Hello, in this video I'll be combining Baby Yoda and Pikachu. I do talk in the beginning, using words out of my stupid mouth, so if you want to skip right to the drawing, here it is. You're welcome. This is my YouTube channel. I opened it back in 2008. I was in university at the time, and logging back onto here, just seeing my old stuff, it's pretty strange. I'd originally planned to use this channel to upload my artwork. I was particularly into video art, often made from my 2 megapixel Sony Ericsson phone camera. Logging back into here and watching those videos again, it's like watching them for the first time. Don't get me wrong, they deserve the 3 views that they do have. But it was really kind of a walk down memory lane for me watching them again. Now I know you're here for the drawing of Pikachu, not to listen to some old man, but I just wanted to spend the first minute or so of this dealing with the thoughts and emotions I had, just seeing all this stuff again after 12 years. And it makes me remember the hopes and the dreams that I had back then, and the expectations versus what my life is now. So it did get a bit emotional. But here I am, 12 years later, ready to kickstart this off again. So being more recently inspired by some videos that I had seen, I decided that I wanted to try my hand at speed drawing. Wait, I mean normal drawing, but just sped up. And I was introduced to these things called Copic markers. They're these alcohol-based marker pens that blend into each other. I'd seen them used in other videos, so I thought, that looks really good. So I got the pens. I already have sketchbooks and pencils lying around everywhere. Now I just needed to record what I was doing. This was a tricky one because I've never recorded anything from that top-down angle. Now I already have quite a lot of filming equipment. Quite recently, for various other projects, I've spent a considerable amount of money. There's cameras, microphones, microphone stands, studio lights, these chocolate things that I can't stop buying. Then of course there's the actual Copic markers themselves. They are not cheap. So I didn't really want to spend any more money on a special top-down stand. And for some reason I was convinced that I could do a DIY project and make one by myself. So that's exactly what I tried to do. This camera angle here was one that was pretty good, but I did want that top-down aesthetic. I had the idea to buy some foam board and kind of knot together a rudimentary platform that would sit above my computer. So I went ahead and sketched out a rough idea. And I ended up with something I could possibly build. I decided it would be most convenient and easiest if I just filmed on my old phone. So I cut out a holder for it out of the foam board. Then I cut a brace for the platform. I glue gunned the holder together. Then I cut a hole out of the big piece of foam board that I had. At this point it was beginning to take shape. I used a cast iron weight from a dumbbell to counterbalance the weight of the foam. To be honest, that's the most useful thing I've done with my dumbbells in about 7 years. And that was about it. I had a fully armed, operational, top-down recorder. It was also the first time that I'd burnt myself from the glue gun. Which wasn't a nice experience, as you expect. But this is the result. I'm actually quite pleased with that. Sure, it's not an ideal long-term solution, but for now it's just fine. But I still needed to give it a real test. And that, my friends, brings us to the subject of this video. I actually had a studio light to the left-hand side of me here, and I didn't really think about how being left-handed would affect it from the shadow, but I don't think it looks too bad. And I actually recorded this at about 10 or 11 at night, even though it looks like the middle of a bright day here. So really impressed with that studio light. As you can probably tell by the name of the channel, I'm a big Pokemon fan, and everyone likes Baby Yoda. So after a rough sketch, which I'll show to you at the end, I set out to combine these two creatures and make the cutest character ever. So there you go. I don't think that's too bad for a Copic beginner. I think I can say my top-down device worked. And there were some issues like my stupid head getting in the shot sometimes. But I think this is good for now. Here's the original practice drawing I did. That gave me the idea to do this video in the first place. I did this before I had the Copic fine liners, so I had to do all the lines in Sharpie. But no matter what you think of this video, I'm sure we can all agree that it's better than that. And I'm looking forward to doing more stuff, and I'm hoping that some of you at least will stick around for it. Anyway, that's the video. Thanks.